Fort Magical Eye of Siam พัทยาค่ะก็วันนี้จะเป็นครั้งแรกที่จะเห็นหิมะค่ะก็เขาไม่ได้บอกก็คือครั้งแรกเลยก็เลยอยากจะชวนพวกพี่ๆแล้วก็เพื่อนมาดูขอบคุณค่ะ
อุ้ยหนาวอ
่
ะ
เห็นเขาว่าข้างในมันหนาวค่ะก็มันเป็นอุปกรณ์ที่ต้องทำความอบอุ่นกับร่างกาย
ฟองเข้าไปเลย
เข้าไปเลยซุกแล้วเห็นเขาพูดว่าติดลบ10องศาค่ะก็คาดหวังว่าจะมาสนุกให้เต็มที่ค่ะมันคงจะสนุกสำหรับวันนี
้บรรยากาศข้างๆชั้นล่าง
ก็วันนี้ก็พาสแตมมาเที่ยวเพราะว่าหลังจากซ้อมมาก็พามารีแลกซ์ครับจำเป็นไหมก็คือผมว่าก็น่าจะต้องมีบ้างครับเพราะว่าจากการซ้อมมวยก็มันก็เหนื่อยอยู่แล้วเครียดอยู่แล้วก็ไม่ค่อยได้ไปที่ไหนเพราะว่าส่วนมากก็จะเล่นดังคุยอะไรกันอยู่ในค่ายครับ
เดี๋ยวเข้าไป
I'm at my gym, Boxing Works. I'd say it's one of our lighter days, where we really worked on some techniques.
Counter punches, yes. Finish somewhere else other than.
She trains all the time, but really things are starting to get more focused. A lot of repetition of some of the things we're working on, defensively and offensively speaking, counters as well. A lot of reps today, a lot of drilling. Knowing Janet, she probably said it was a light day, something like that, but it was a pretty decent clip today. It wasn't super duper intense from start to end, but it depends on what we're working.
I feel good. I feel like we keep chipping away a little bit at a time with what we're trying to get better at and what we're trying to show for the fight. So I'm looking forward to the next couple weeks and seeing how it goes.
With the rope, just incorporating a little bit more head movement, boxing centric type training versus a strict Thai boxing. So not the most traditional of sort of Thai approaches to training today, but again, that's how we do it.
Again.
Janet Todd of the USA. As you learn speed, angles, and precision, and look out for the raw, sheer power of Stan Fairtex of Thailand. Janet Todd, a Pan American Muay Thai champion. Stan Fairtex, a world kickboxing champion. Both ladies just dipping their toes in the proverbial water early on, seeing what each other has to offer. We know in the clinch that Stan's dumps are tremendous. She locks a leg, tries to counter off the right. And referee Onari keeps it clean.
Go!
Janet Todd, what does she have in her bag of tricks? A 33-year-old from Los Angeles, California. A 21-year-old from Thailand. Stan Fairtex checks the low kick. Straight right hand down the center corridor. Janet Todd has never competed with four-ounce gloves before. How will she handle the power when those gloves land to the jaw? Roby with the lead hand, goes to the inside thigh, checks the low kick, does Todd. Catching counter there from Stan Fairtex.
Go!
It's Muay Thai rules, so referee Onari should not be cautioning Stan right there. She's allowed to catch and counter all night long. Jabs here from Janet Todd, tucking the chin, looking through her brow. A very patient contest so far from these two martial artists.
You're just taking that time, feeling that process out, but I like the way Janet Todd is moving forward. She's initiating a lot of the exchanges, but Stamp is able to come right through the middle when she catches that body kick, and she's really found her range with those punches.
Jab two, nicely done there from Janet Todd. Just applied a little pressure around the nose of Stamp. Stamp checks the low kick, Todd goes upstairs again. Counter right hand there from Stan Fairtex. world's kickboxing champion left of screen. The Pan-American Muay Thai champion right of screen. Cuts off Stamp's movement. Nicely done there from Todd. Jab overhand right. Doubles up on the right hand to Stamp Fairtex. Now they clinch a chunk for the knees. Stamp will try and ragdoll her here. Gut munching knees from the tie. And referee Onari calls break. 5 rounds, 3 minutes apiece for the World Muay Thai Championship. Double jab from Todd. No right hand for company. Back against the ropes here, high kick from Todd, counter right hand, Todd takes the punishment, Stamp Fairtex, a succession of right hands.
And that's what's really making the difference here, is that catch and counter. She caught the head kick and then delivered 4 unanswered blows
and again, right down the middle. And counters from Stamp Fairtex. It's proving the undoing of Jenna Todd in the opening round. Now there's 2 things Todd can do to rectify that situation. 1, really pivot and talk and follow through with the kick. Or 2, retract the kick as quick as possible.
Yeah, she's got to turn the hip right there. She has to turn the hips, point her knee the other direction, and jerk that knee back as quickly as she can, because Stamp's got a vice-type grip on that body kick. Nice little combination initiated by Janet Todd, but then Stamp just coming right down the middle, landing that too. Janet with a nice little left hand right there, but that right hand of Stamp Fairtex is taking Janet Todd to town. It's just coming right the middle. You've got to see Janet Todd get that kick and retract it back, or she's got to put a whole lot of mustard on it, like you said, Michael.
3 judges ringside, scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winning boxer 10 points, the less dominant boxer 9 points. Our sellout crowd inside the mighty Singapore Indoor Stadium. Our main event for the ONE Super Series Muay Thai World Title. Well, kickboxing champion Stan Fairtex in the camouflage green. And American Muay Thai champion Jenna Todd in the black and maroon. Todd controlling center ring, jabs out. Stamp thrust the right hand, outside leg kick from Jenna Todd. Stamp faints. Todd keeping her guard very high. Good check to the inside leg kick from the American. Goes to the outside five. Stamp doubles up on it. Fairtex leads him with the right hand. They clinch up now. A little tango against the ropes. Knee from Jenna Todd.
Stop.
Knees from Fairtex. Nothing scoring with any point making. And referee Onari breaks them. Let's see if Stamp gets up centering here. Janet probing with the lead hand. The project armbands around the biceps of Janet Todd, all part of the very superstitious Muay Thai ritual. Usually those armbands are blessed by a Buddhist monk. A tradition that dates back around 1,500 years, a very old martial art Muay Thai. Outside leg kick from Janet Todd, that'll score for it. We really haven't seen Stamp Fairtex wind up her incredible power yet. I dare say, though, it is coming soon. There's the right hand from Stamp Fairtex. There's another right from the tie. And she rattles in her knee. They twist and waltz in center ring. And referee Onari breaks them.
At least the first 90 seconds, Janet Todd has been a lot more active with this round. She's been putting the pressure on, utilizing those hands in better combinations. And she's not throwing the body kicks as well. So that's not giving Stamp the ability to catch that kick and throw that right hand.
Evasion there from Fairtex. Stamp throws the right hand down the center corridor. You can't just throw the one shots here, though. When you throw the right, you've got to cut underneath with the legs. Bring the left hook over the top for company.
Like the adjustment that they made in between that first and second round. Obviously, it was very clear that the corners said to Janet Todd, do not throw that right body kick anymore.
They clinch up center of the ring. Stan Fairtex may look to dump Janet Todd here. Todd gets off a knee. Referee breaks it. Stan Fairtex, kickboxing world champion, one of 120 martial arts world champions on our 500-plus athlete roster here at ONE Championship. Jack to the against Stan Fairtex. Jack to again. Smack bang with the kisser. A power packed punch there from Stan Fairtex. Maybe the hardest punch of the contest so far.
You can see that Janet Todd's face is starting to get touched up from that right hand of Stan Fairtex.
Haven't really seen Stamp's roundhouse kicks coming to the body and the head of Jenna Todd, yet as they did when she won the world title over Kai Ting Chuan. First down, second down, let's go to the tap. Chatri Sitchin's on the CEO and chairman of One Championship alongside an absolute legend, Yonsen Kai Ai Wei Fairtex, multiple world Muay Thai champion, one Super Series athlete. He takes on the great Andy Sauer March 31st in Tokyo.
Sam Fairtex getting a little bit of advice. It'll be interesting to see if she starts utilizing more kicks in this round. Right now, she's just throwing that left hand. Now, Janet, what adjustments is she going to make inside that round? The first two rounds, probably on the side of Sam Fairtex because of that right hand. That right hand is landing over and over again. We got to see Janet Todd start moving her head. She cannot stay directly in front of Sam Fairtex.
Mitch, let's talk a little about traditional Muay Thai. In traditional Muay Thai, it is a five-rounder. So are we going to see Stan Fairtex start to power up here, start to rise the mercury, lift the adrenaline, up the aggressive meter, third of five. Traditionally, this is where the Thais really pick up the pace.
Yeah, they turn it on in the third and then let everything go in the fourth. And usually they taper off in the fifth if they haven't won. But right now, Stamp's not letting it go. This is a boxing match with knees at this point.
Nice knee there from Stan Fairtech to the upper rib cage. There's a gut muncher from Janet Todd. A real tassel referee, Onari, breaks it. The Atomweight Muay Thai world title on the line. Janet Todd, a Pan American champion. Stan Fairtech's a world kickboxing champion. Stan leads him with the right hand, downward elbow. Crossing elbow from Stan Fairtech. Both ladies cracking away to the chin. Now the knee trade. A knee guard there from Todd.
And Todd's able to get off some of these elbows when Stamp's initiating that clinch. I like that change of strategy. But we're also not seeing the dumps that we saw in Stamp Fairtex's match with Tai Ching Chuang. She's not utilizing the dumps because she's not getting that forward pressure from Janet Todd. Janet Todd's not rushing forward. So Stamp doesn't have that momentum to twist and torque Janet Todd.
Stan Fairtex dumped Kai Ting Chuan all night long in their world title matchup in Bangkok. Haven't seen a dump though here from the world's kickboxing champion against the Pan American Muay Thai champion Janet Todd. Todd thrusts out a jab. Little damage under the right eye of the American from Los Angeles, California. Haven't also seen Stan Fairtex really wind up those roundhouse kicks. It's been mostly a boxing match from the world's kickboxing champion. Little graze, little cut maybe under the left eye, I should say the right eye of Stan Fairtex. Circles off to the power side of Janet Todd. Todd turns her, walks to center ring. Arms up high, turned outwards. Nice right hand there from Stan Fairtex. There's the first dump from the world kickboxing champion.
Michael, you gotta wonder, maybe something's wrong with the feet because this is a... I mean, this is a complete weapon that is absolutely missing from Stan Fairtex. Last time we saw her, she threw that right kick over and over again to the body, legs, and head of Tai Ching Chuang. But here, she's rarely thrown it at all.
Checks the low kick to Fairtex. Shoots the jab over the top. She's had one dump here in the third round. Are we going to see more? Roundhouse kick to the waist there from Stan Fairtex.
There's one.
Nice counter right hand after the jab, too, from Janet Todd.
Third set in the third round.
Todd. Got to use plenty of head movement, keeps the lead leg very light. Now the reason for keeping the lead leg so light in Muay Thai, it's twofold. One, you want to be able to check the low kicks. Two, you want to be able to fire out your teep kick, your front kick, to keep your opponent at bay. Jab two, kangaroo from Stan Fairtex. Outside leg kick, Janet Todd checks it. Fairtex. That roundhouse kick ends the third round. Now we're going into round four. As Mitch said earlier, it's round four where the Thais truly accelerate. It's round four where the Thais truly put on the pressure.
There's that clinch. This is where I think Janet Todd starts to let go of some elbows. Yeah, there's a nice little sharp elbow. Downward elbow landed with a knee, but then Stamp came over the top with that right hand. Janet comes forward and they exchange punches. This is a fourth round of this title matchup. This is a very important round. Right now, the scorecards are probably pretty close, you know, but we're seeing back and forth action. Janet's starting to get her timing down. She's starting to push the pace, but Stan Fairtex is answering with that right hand. We did see her start to throw more kicks, start to do more work. with that right leg, but not a lot.
Sold out in Singapore for one championship call to greatness wherever you're watching around the world in 138 countries. Do you score it so far for Jenna Todd? Do you score it for Stan Fairtex? Fairtex, the world's kickboxing champion. One of 120 martial arts champions on our roster. Jab too early on from Stan. Outside leg kick from Todd. Stamp with the right hand between the eyes. Jenna Todd's got to lift her work rate. Got to start putting down some points. Landing some telling salvos on Stan Fairtex. Stan leads him with an overhand elbow. Moves to a clinch. Nice work from the top. Stan Fairtex. Will we see her wind up those roundhouse kicks off the back leg? The ones she used to break down Kai Ting Chuong when she won the Atomweight Kickboxing World Strap.
Jenna Todd's got good reaction time. A nice little sweep there. I like the leg kicks of Jenna Todd. She took out the foot there of Stan Fairtex. The leg kicks are working.
Fairtex backs her up with the right hand. Checks the low kick, moves in for the grapple, charge for the knees, throws it to the left waist section. Crunch it armband, flying off the right biceps of Jenna Todd. They'll take it out of the ring. Todd jabbing to the outside leg kick. Fairtex studying, looking for an opening in the arm of the American. Low kick to the quadriceps there, to that common peroneal nerve about four fingers breadth above the knee. That's where Muay Thai combatants kick over and over again to deaden an opponent's leg. As we said earlier, we haven't seen the usual kicking arsenal from Stan Fairtex tonight. What we have seen is a lot more boxing. And there's another right hand between the eyes of Jenna Todd. Jab two from Fairtex. Want to cut under with the right leg. And now it's Todd's turn to go to work. Evades the roundhouse kick. The world kickboxing champion, another jab two. That combination is bread and butter for the Thai. Now clinches up. And she throws the knees on the inside, puts a knee guard on. And referee Onari breaks them. 40 seconds to go, Mitch, fourth and five.
You can see the swelling right above the left eye of Janet Todd. It's from that right hand that lands over and over again from Stan Fairtex. You see a different Stan Fairtex than we saw in her first title bout. We're not seeing the kicks as much, and we're not seeing the dancing. You can see when she's dancing, she's having fun out there. That's her confidence. That's how good Janet Todd is performing in this matchup, because she is, Stan doesn't have that same sort of swagger.
A cerebral performance from Jenna Todd so far. You saw her put on the knee guard moments ago. Here come the knees again from Stan Fairtex. Trick takedown, nicely done from Stan Fairtex. Dump number two from Stan. By this time against Kai Ting Chuong, she must have had at least 15, I'd say. One more round to go between these two amazing martial artists.
Let's take a look at that right hand, just over and over again, right to the eye of Janet Todd. It is just a perfect weapon. She comes over the top of Janet Todd's left hand and just lands it right there. There, very well could be the greatest kickboxer of his generation, the multi-time world champion, Giorgio Petrosian, enjoying this Muay Thai contest.
Okay, Mitch, let's play coach. Fifth and final round, what are you telling Jenna Todd to do?
Man, Jenna Todd needs a knockout at this point. The hands aren't getting it done. You got to go shin to chin and sleep Stan Fairtex if you want to walk away with the belt out of the stadium.
It's time to pull out all the stops. It's time to throw caution to the wind for America's Jenna Todd. In front of a sellout crowd here in the Singapore Indoor Stadium, the main event of one championship call to greatness for the world atomweight Muay Thai title. Eight touch gloves, 4 ounce gloves. There's no room for error. These gloves will hurt you. Big right hand to open up proceedings for Stan Fairtex. Jab from Todd, checks the low kick. You sense a little more urgency now about the American Jenna Todd. Jab two to a left hook, good three-punch combination. Fairtex goes downstairs.
Now Janet's trying to put hands on Stan Fairtex, piecing her up. I like it.
Double right hand, nicely done there from Fairtex. eye guard here from Janet Todd, swelling around the left eye. Double jab, high kick, tried for the headache maker. Stamp ties her up, knee guard from Todd. Stamp tries to dump her, but the ropes held up the American champion.
That's what Todd needs to do, wrap that shin around the head of Stamp Fairtex. She needs to sleep her. She needs to knock her out at this point. Good. Janet Todd putting those punches together.
Two jabs from Janet Todd. Stamp Fairtex does a quick count of her teeth. Another knee guard and Fairtex dumps her. Third dump of the contest for Stamp Fairtex. Now, while they necessarily won't score, it's certainly not a knockdown if you're only watching Muay Thai for the first time, but psychologically it means that Janet Todd has to pick herself up off the canvas every time she gets dumped. There's a straight right hand from Stamp Fairtex. Jab two from Todd. Crossing elbow from Fairtex. Now we're seeing the aggressive meter turn up. It's all hands and elbows. A clipping left hook from Todd. A two-punch combination from the American. This is more like it from Janet Todd. She pulls the head down, tries to thread the knee.
Those hands are starting to work. You can see Stamp Fairtex has let off the gas a little bit, and Janet Todd is starting to come back. She's landing with that jab. I like that left hand from Janet Todd. I want to see more of that.
Front kick from Todd to a turning left hand. Stamp Fairtex is blowing heavy, folks. Stamp Fairtex breathing through an open mouth. It's never a good sign. And Todd probing with the lead hand. Nice left hook there from Janet. Just needed a little more start behind it. But in this fifth round, she's had more punch than a high school prom. Sticks out the teeth kick. Stamp tries to sweep out the supporting leg. Jab from Stamp backs her up to
Race.
That was now from the world kickboxing champion. And another one from Stamp Fairtex. Will she go three in a row? She settles for a hook. But Stamp's backing herself in the corner. And Janet Todd lets flurry. Toe to toe for a moment. Stamp Fairtex through the short straw. Front kick from Todd. Final seconds. Is there one big salvo left? We're going down to the judges in Singapore. Who's going to win? Who's going to take home championship gold? Wherever you're watching, in 138 countries, scored on a 10-point must system. You give the winner of the round 10 points, the less dominant boxer 9 points. Who won tonight?
Look at Janet Todd, found another gear in the fifth and final round and started to put things together. Really piecing up Todd. That jab was finding a home in the fifth. Over and over, she was landing with the left hand. There's Stamp coming across. Boom, connecting with a nice little elbow. But Janet doesn't let it go unanswered. Answers back with hands of her own. I would like to see another couple more rounds of that one.
The one championship, Atomweight Muay Thai world title. Will Stamp Fairtex become a two-sport world champion, our first ever? Or will Janet Todd take the gold back to the USA? Tremendous performance from two outstanding martial artists. Janet Todd, for mine, had the final round 10-9. Before that, though, Stamp Fairtex certainly stamped her authority with the hands, with some elbows and knees. May be in for a close one here in Singapore. Do you have it for the world's kickboxing champion? One of 120 martial arts world champions on our roster, Stamp Fairtex, or for Janet Todd. Here's Don Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, we have Hua Fung Te, group president of ONE Championship. And now, after five rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, the ONE Super Series Atomweight Muay Thai World Champion from the red corner, Stamp Fairtex.
She's made history. A two-sport world champion
Step Fairtex takes the gold in Singapore. An outpouring of emotion for the 21-year-old phenom. Given one of the toughest matches of her career by the valiant, the resilient Jenna Todd. A rain of gold over the ring in Singapore. The rain of gold over the shoulder of Stan Fairtex. Stan Fairtex now a two-sport world champion. The first two-sport world champion in one championship history. What a moment for Stan Fairtex. What a moment for Thailand.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.